Hey everybody, and welcome back to another segment. I decided after doing my first test one test review that I actually wanted to spend a little bit more time going over the stretchy trot and everything that you need to really create the best movement that you can. So here we are again. Now, I'm sure a lot of you have a lot of different ways that you try to ask for your stretch, a lot of different scenarios, and I'm sure growing up, everyone has said, okay, we're gonna stretch, we're gonna have this horse nice, long, and low, and that's gonna be that. But despite this, you end up still seeing a lot of issues in the fundamentals of the stretch, and especially in the test, which is a little disappointing, but so easily fixed. So I think that the first thing that actually really needs to be said is that not every horse is going to do well starting off with a stretch in their warm-up. And I know I'm probably going to get some looks for this, but just kind of sit here and think about it. Maybe you've seen a horse, or maybe you've known a horse. You go, you trot around, and they're kind of plodding along, but you're using your hands to try and get more of a stretch in. He's kind of dropping on his forehand, he's a little heavy, and his hind end is falling out from underneath him instead of creating the purpose of the stretch, which is to encourage that staying engagement and to allow them to come over their backs and swing through and follow the connection that they want to obtain. Now, the first major mistake you see in most of the tests in the stretchy circle is that you have people trying to use their hands way too much. The whole point of this is to show that your horse wants to stretch into the consistent and steady connection that you've built throughout your ride. You want them to say, wow, this connection was very comfortable. I want to go back into that and continue to use my body. I want to make that my option. And by using your hands, all you're doing is throwing them off balance. So you'll see the tempo and the rhythm change, you'll probably see their entire balance and their way of going just completely fall out. Some horses will end up losing their shoulder or their haunch, and overall you can tell. Even if they don't tell you, they can tell. The next mistake that you end up seeing a lot of people do is just throwing away the reins. They throw away their entire connection and they say, all right, here, take a stretch. But that's the same kind of thing, right? They want to be able to follow the soft contact that leads them in. If you just throw away everything that you've given them and everything that they're comfortable with, you're not going to get anything. You're not going to encourage them to stretch. What really needs to be done is think about it as you want your horse to stretch, you're trotting around. Open up your elbow angle a little bit, bring your hands forward. If they stretch down into that little bit that you've given them, then start to feed the reins out of your hands. Don't start off by just throwing it all away, but see and test the water. See where they're comfortable and see where their balance ends. Every horse has a limit to as far as they can go down before they start losing their balance. So by throwing away those reins, you don't give them the chance to find out where they can and can't balance. And then again, you've got the same problem that you have with almost too much hand, where you still don't have right where you need to be. And then, of course, we've got almost the hardest one of all to fix. And this one has kind of been my problem at the beginning, and it took me a long time to fix. But you can see it in the video very obviously. It's falling forward and collapsing that upper body when you try to follow with the stretch. Now, sometimes this can happen because you feel like you don't have enough reins, or because you feel like you need to go down with them for some whatever sort of subconscious reason it is for all of us, right? But the thing is, with there, you can already see in that video where it helped get her on her forehand, right? You added that weight up to that front instead of imitating her saying, I'm going to stay up tall. I'm still going to hold my body. I'm going to be correct. And we're just going to lengthen the frame in this balance. And instead, we just say when we throw our bodies forward, it's all right, we're out for the count. Here we go. And then the final thing I guess I want to cover is just don't be afraid, right? So you know that your horse has to have energy and that you don't want his hind end falling out from underneath him, right? So how do you avoid that? Are you going to try and keep the trot very slow into your stretch? Or are you going to let it come forward? Are you going to let that same working trot that you had at the beginning and keep that same pace and let it stretch out from there, right? So that's really kind of what everyone wants to see, ideally, is that your pace and your tempo and your rhythm, none of it changes. the only thing that changes is the amount that your horse is stretching down. And that's kind of going to help avoid where their haunches, like their hind end, trails out behind them. They're not swinging. They're not really using their backs or carrying you. And at that point, when you finally got that and you've got that horse so solid, that's when you know you've done a good job. Pat yourself on the back. If not, every horse has their own journey. With my mare, it took her quite a while to understand the whole stretching thing. She would stab the ground down and then come up and then stab down and come up because she wasn't quite sure where her balance is. If you're at that stage, that's fine. That is totally okay. Be conservative. Let it have that same quality. Just don't ask for as much stretch yet. And eventually, when they get comfortable with that, you ask a little more and a little more. And then eventually you've got this wonderful, beautiful, balanced stretch. Don't give up on it. It is definitely worth all of the effort. The judges love it. It is my favorite move. You got this.